So you wake up in the morning, go to the bathroom, brush your teeth, maybe even you take a shower. You got good hygiene. Good for you, man. And then it is time to eat. So you eat some breakfast. Maybe you're having pancakes today. Woo. Rock on. And then you probably have some caffeine, right? You have a cup of Joe, maybe a Celsius, and the productivity juices are flowing. Now it's go time. It's time for work. So you head out the door, you get ready for work, you're there, and then bang, you hit the wall. And you start to yawn, and then you're like, why am I so tired? See, the answer to that question is in the story I just told. Let me explain. So if you're anything like me, I used to eat breakfast and it was a great one. I'd have 4 eggs, maybe even 5. I'd have hash brown, 2 pieces of turkey bacon, and a bagel. And in doing this, I'd notice every single time after I ate, I just get tired. I get super duper slumped. I'd feel lethargic. I'd feel slow. All the tasks that I previously had the energy to do, I just didn't anymore. And the reason being is in the breakfast I was eating. When we eat these highly processed carbs, it slows us down. It's hard for our body to digest. And to conceptualize this, imagine, dude, right? I want you to film a video like this, but before you film the video, you just stuff your freaking face with pasta. Then I ask you to come up and film this video. You'd be tired. You'd probably be slow. You maybe yawn. Probably wouldn't have the energy to do it. It's the same exact thing. So to prevent this afternoon slump, it actually happens beforehand. Breakfast is a modern creation, dude. So you don't need to eat it. And if you want to, because you're trying to gain weight, whatever it is, then just try and eliminate the processed carbs and be good to your body. Because personally, I just run on coffee and water until my first meal. And that's not all there is to the morning slash afternoon slump. There is another culprit that is taking your energy and it's making you feel tired and you're looking at it. It is that guy. It is your phone. And the reason being is you get sucked into this thing. We go on social media, we check our email, our text, the whole nine. And every single time we do this, not only are we taking our energy, but it's actually stealing dopamine from us. See, if I were to ask you right now to check your screen time, and I'm a betting man, I'd put $1,000 that it's over 4 hours a day. And hey, I'm guilty of it too, right? We all have our reasons why we use our phone. But the premise of it is the days where I have little to no energy, little to no will to live, comes from days where I'm living in my phone. I'm checking social media too much. I'm watching too much YouTube. Maybe it's TikTok for you. Whatever it is, get out of the digital world and get in the real one. The more and more you continue to check your phone, you just get less of a return. And every single time the hit goes down, you get less and less dopamine and your baseline gets lower and lower and lower. So your energy just gets lower and lower and lower. Not to mention your phone also takes your focus. It's gonna pretty much remove all productivity you had before. It's gonna keep you distracted. So get rid of the phone as much as possible. Put it in another room, whatever you gotta do. So how do you fix this? You need to avoid your phone as much as possible, especially in the early parts of the day. So what I do, I turn on Do Not Disturb so I don't get any notifications. I also delete social media. So before I go to bed, I delete Instagram, Snapchat, whatever you use, just delete it. So then when you wake up, it's not even tempting because it's not there. Now, here is a curveball, some secret sauce for you guys. Best way I found to maintain good energy throughout the day is to get oxygen to the brain. So what I do in the morning is I get my blood pumping, whether it's a run, a lift, breathing exercises, whatever it is, I just get a lot of oxygen to my brain. And the reason being is that's why we're tired. When we yawn, it's actually a way for our body to get in oxygen. When I'm tired or slumped, I'm starting to yawn, I just do some push-ups. I'll do anywhere from, 20, 30, maybe 40 push-ups. And after that, you're not tired. Like you are ready to go. That's like a shot out of a cannon. Another thing too is just quick breathing. Like seriously, just start breathing really fast, like almost hyperventilating, and that's gonna wake your body up. Maybe you work at home or you get a break, go to the sauna, go for a run, do a lift, cardio, whatever it is, even a walk. All these things will increase your energy and prevent that slump. Now, I got a good and a quick story for you guys. So if we go back thousands and thousands of years ago to our ancestors, it was the first alarm clock. The sun, that guy, he's bright today. But that guy, right? So when he rose, we'd wake up. It was our natural signal to wake up. And then when he would set, it was our natural signal to go to bed. So in doing this, that's the form of our circadian rhythm. It would kind of dictate things we do and don't do based off the time of day. Now, fast forward back to reality, it's completely different, right? You may have lights all over your place, whatever it is. And when you have that, it signals your body it's time to wake up. So if you get tired or you get sleepy, make sure you're not in a dark environment, because that's going to tell your body, hey, it's time to rest. And the opposite is true. So if you're trying to go to bed, make sure you don't have all these fluorescent lights on. A pro tip, I use candles before I go to bed and it helps me sleep. So we can use this to our advantage by getting sunlight early. So Andrew Huberman, pretty smart dude, right? He says to get sunlight in within an hour of waking up. And it's completely true. Just go outside. It's kind of weird, but just stare into the sky. Don't look in the sun, but look into the sky. And that's going to tell your body, yo, it is time to wake up. And it's going to help get your circadian rhythms on track. Because realistically, it makes zero sense to be tired at, you know, mid to late afternoon. It makes no sense. Another thing that I found was lack of water intake. We got to make sure we're getting enough fluids in. Maybe it's electrolytes, whatever it is. These things that I just listed helped me out. I don't have an afternoon slump anymore. I have good energy. I'm pretty well rounded consistently. And I hope this helps you guys, because it's funny. I literally paid a doctor 6 months ago to answer this question for me. I was tired all the time. I was just like you. Like, I was tired. I was lethargic, slow. And it just kept happening every single day and I couldn't fix it. So these are the things that worked for me. There was no magic pill. I just did these simple things. So it worked for me. I hope it works for you. I hope you guys found some value in this. Lastly, special announcement. If you are into self-improvement, the gym, want to make more money, whatever it is, join the community. I just launched a free group on school. It's absolutely free. But it will not stay that way for long. So once we get to 50 members, we're going to start charging people to walk through the door. Get in while you can, because it's free and it's awesome. We post workouts, daily wins, great stuff to not only inspire other people, but to hold other people accountable. So all that good stuff is there for you guys in the link in the description. Go check it out, and I will see you guys in the next one.